Like some all first verse shit.
Fat Boy. Damn, I'm wild.
Shout out to Damn, I'm wild.
Fat Boy, what's going on?
Shout out to Damn, I'm wild.
Damn, I'm wild.
Damn, I'm wild, man. Shout out to you, brother.
Shout out to Fat Boy. Damn, I'm wild.
Damn, I'm wild.
Check out Damn, I'm wild.
Man, Fat Boy, cook up.
Man, Fat Boy say, I respect the culture. I advise you niggas to do the same.
Easy to block, Captain.
Rye hit me with a new plug. He said, let's get rich. I had to make a choice. To use the infamel for the dope or for my infant, but you don't get this.
Verse stumbles.
If I say I'ma shoot something, I mean it, my nigga. I'm all on you. Go ahead and check my blood pressure, pussy. I lift the arm for you. I talk different.
That's wild.
This is a crazy fucking battle. I plan on recapping this shit. Y'all gonna wanna go watch this shit because when I do the recap for this one, you don't wanna be lost. A lot of shit going on right now, bro. You got A-Verb versus Loaded Lux just dropped on YouTube.
Ew! YouTube!
Yo, what she trying to say? But listen, when she don't say it her way, it sound proper. Yo, like, hey, we not saying it proper, though.
Nah, it's not about saying it proper, it's just the YouTube. Like, why is it happening with an U? Why is it an U?
It was like, yo,
U. What you doing? So niggas told me his name was Bird. I said, Bird. Barry?
Don't do that, Jazz. I be seeing you trying to slide Baltimore niggas, and I fuck with you, but don't do that.
I'm always watching.
You also got the entire card fully released now for Volume 5. So we got time to talk about that at some point this week if I get a chance to. You got Chilla Jones and Rum Nitty going back and forth online. You got Danny Myers and Hollow. You got Hollow confirming that he definitely has a battle with Mook already locked in place. So that's officially going down. There's a lot of shit going on in battle rap right now, bruh. But today we're going to talk about royalty, man. A dope card. We already talking about shit being booked for 2020. God damn. That's fucking crazy, yo. The year blowing by. Little throwback intro, man. Something different. If you've been around for a while, you know what this little clip is. We're going to talk royalty, man. Let's lock the fuck in.
Marquise, what's up, man? Let's get the show started, man. Let's go!
Big homie doing seasons, hit his J-Pay just to feed him. It's cold-blooded killers like I breed him. Left him at the scene, his mother flew up when she seen him. Percocets and Kush, I'm playing spades with my demons. Aftermath tragic, feds gave him 24 attachments. Never judge my grandma for her habits. Passed the pistol down to a savage. Pull out on the plug, call static. Caught him with his daughter, he ain't have it. Eating with the apes, capping when it's late. How that judge get that nigga 30 with a straight face? Heard them bitches left him stinking when that bag left. Pray to God that he'll say my name with his last breath. Homicide where I reside at. Loyalty of niggas that'll kill when it's combats. Homicide where I reside at. Loyalty of niggas that'll kill when it's combat.
You can call me Fat Boy, man. AKA. I'm not in the NBA, but I am the two guard. Shout out to Jazz. AKA, I might not be the man, but I'm right next to guard. Shout out to you, and you. Don't adjust your value, Jazz. The accent is just fucked up. I'm from Baltimore. You should already know. Let's just start the show. Shout out to all the Wild Goons, all the Lady Wild Goons. Look, I'm not going to hold y'all for a long time today. I know a lot of my most recent content been fucking 20, 25, 27 minutes per video and shit. And I know it'd be a struggle to get through all of that shit. But, hey, I appreciate y'all rocking with me regardless. I try to make it as entertaining as possible all the way through to keep your interest. You know what I'm saying? But, hey, sometimes a nigga can't sit for 20 minutes and listen to shit. So, if you don't, I still love you anyway, baby. You hear me? All right, so let's talk this royalty card. First of all, at the bottom of this card, you got Diesel versus Cheddar, and you got Casey J versus Miss Merck. Listen, man, I don't. Look, man. I'm sorry. Listen, I don't. You know what I mean? I mean you no disrespect. But I just. All jokes aside, you know what I'm saying? No disrespect to them. I don't follow enough of their content to sit here and pretend that I got all this analysis for these niggas to break down their battle. I just don't. Shout out to them. Like any other opening battles on any other card, if them battles warm up, we'll watch them all the way through. We'll talk about them later. If not, man, you're going to eat some chicken wings, take a smoke break, take a shit, whatever else you got to do while them battles is going on to be ready for the shit you do care about. Right? All right. Let's keep it 1,000. Keeping it. Fuck that shit. Keeping it 1,000. Skipping right past it. Next. All right. So the next battles after them two, you got the 2-on-2 battle. You got Misfit and Cortez versus the Lokes. Shout out to the Lokes, man. Coffee Brown and Geechee Gotti. Listen, Coffee Brown is relatively new. Geechee Gotti, I guess, I mean, still relatively new. He's been rocking for a couple of years now. He's been that nigga outside for a little minute now. You're going up against some seasoned vets, man. You're going up against Cortez and Misfit, who they got a lot of experience. I just feel like they do a lot more. They're gonna scheme, they're gonna punch, they're gonna angle, they're gonna do a little performing here and there. They're gonna try to get in their fucking bag. These ain't some fucking rookies. These ain't some niggas that's just getting started or no shit. You playing with some vets. You understand what I'm saying? I think they just do a lot more. The thing about Coffee Brown and Geechee that I don't like is the fact that Geechee is very, very, very punch heavy, obviously. Coffee Brown has her own style. I feel like there's a lot more work to make what they do mix and mix well. Who knows? It could blend perfectly. I don't know. We won't know until the battle happens. With Misfit and Cortez being like fucking family, obviously spending a lot of time together, being cool, you know what I'm saying? They definitely have a better chemistry up to this point. They definitely should have an easier time formulating chemistry and putting their content together, some shit that should be easy to make work. My honest, easy, quick answer, I feel like on cam, all that Compton, that gangster shit is probably going to hit a lot better on camera, unless Cortez and Misfit, like I said, get into this performance bag. The gangster shit probably just gonna hit hard on cam. I'm gonna go with Coffee and Geechee on cam that first watch, but on the playback, once you sit with it for a while, it's probably a lot closer than that. So this could definitely go 2-1 either way, but on first watch, I got Coffee and Geechee Gotti for the win. Next up, Tory Doe versus Chess. Listen, right now, shout out to Ben Swayze. I don't want my cave game card revoked. You hear me? I'm right now, just for behind the scenes, I got Rock. You know what I'm saying? This nigga Ben Swayze from Harlem. So he got Rex. You know what I'm saying? I'm cave game right now. You heard? Gang sick. I don't want my card revoked for not picking Chess. But listen, man. Tory Doe is a spectacular talent, a female battle rapper. You cannot sleep on her. You gotta be familiar with Tory Doe. She's had some dope battles over the years. You can't be a fan of battle rap and not know about, like, the remote not working. You can't be. That's just, it's almost fucking impossible. So she's capable of putting on dope performances, giving you haymakers and shit. I'm going with Tory Doe for the upset, and I'm going to tell you why. I don't know how Chess is going to approach a female battle rapper. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure he's going to get in there and spit content like any other night he would. But you battling a female. It's not just going to be some walk for the cake, a cake walk per se. At the end of the day, I think Tory Doe is going to do what she was attempting to do versus Daylight. I'm going to play the clip right here so you can understand exactly what I'm saying.
You did a laugh and you said to accept this battle. I couldn't be in my right state of mind for a minute. I hated you because that was the truest shit. It was like me and my world were locked in orbits until he left in this lunatic. I'm twisted. started to develop this little twitch, and you said your gift rapping. I'm not rap too tight, but I'm gifted. Did you wish I was another little dumb bitch and Christian? Y'all think he's really a god when Hebrew bullshit and scream it to anyone that would listen. It's genocide with this genesis. Yo, bitch, I let the god ride like Pegasus. I know I'm a dick. I'm so ahead of this nigga. Blood gon' pour out him. When my bullets enter, then exit this nigga. I black out. You see white my peace. Prejudice, nigga. Thought you were a rose from concrete. That arose from concrete. You just pendulous, nigga. I'm saddened.
I think at the end of the day, she's going to approach chess the way chess would approach a battle, much like it seems like she was getting ready to go bar for bar with Daylight had that battle actually fucking happen. I don't know. Something just telling me to go with Tory Doe. Obviously, chess is more than capable of winning this battle. But I feel like this is probably going to be battle of the night. Tory Doe is going to, she's going to get out there and try to match his intensity, his energy. You know what I'm saying? She can talk that street shit. She's going to get a little grimy with this nigga. So this should be fun. This should be a fun watch. I got Tory Doe 2-1. It's probably going to be 2-1 either way. Next up on the card. Clearly this could be battle of the night without even trying. Two of the best lyricists in battle rap, not just from the male or female perspective, just period, in battle rap. Two of the best. Rum Nitty versus Official. I don't even gotta tell you how crazy this battle could fucking get. Again, I'm going with the female for the upset. Listen, Rum Nitty is fire. I don't gotta tell you that, but I don't know if this nigga gonna get up there and get cringy. You know how niggas like to start talking about the girl titties and shit and fucking the girl and doing all kinds of, yeah, niggas gonna try to get disrespectful and it might get a little cringy and take away from the material trying to do new shit. Chess, I hate to backtrack, Chess is, you know what I'm saying, having a good year, and you know, hey, you gonna take risks. You gonna try new shit battling a female, and I feel like Rum Nitty gonna do the same thing. You gonna take some risks. It might not go as planned and it could be fire, but I don't know how these niggas is going to play this. This is a different perspective. I know the females is going to come in and try to get busy. They're going to do what they always do. They're not really going to change shit. They're going to talk that shit to these niggas. So nothing's going to really change for them, in my opinion. But we're going to find out. Official can talk that gun bar shit just as good as any fucking body in battle rap. And she from New Orleans. You know what I'm saying? She, you know about Bourbon Street. You know goddamn well there's some rum punchlines and some rum flips coming in this motherfucker you definitely never heard before. She gonna be in a fucking bag. So, we gonna see how it go. I got Official though, 2-1. And then last but not least, the main event. Like I said, we keeping this short and sweet. Miss Hustle versus 40 Bars. I'm gonna get straight to the point. 40 need this battle, and I ain't even talking about just for the win. I'm talking about she need this battle. She need to get some of the stink off of her from Summer Impact. Bruh, 40 is in this trailer talking about, well, I've been the best female battle rapper for the past year, and all of a sudden I have a bad battle and bitches forget who I am and all this other shit. 40, let me tell you something. You didn't just choke on the biggest of stages. You quit. Motherfucker, is you hearing me? You quit a battle on Summer Madness, Summer Impact, however you want to say it. You quit. You don't just wipe that off by saying, I was the best up until that. So, you quit. End of the day, this is the thing about 40. Yeah, it's possible she going to choke, and she got a history of choking when the lights is on. My nigga. This is probably the biggest major card to kick off the year. I don't know if KOTD or RBE is doing something prior to January 11th, but it's probably going to be the first big event of the year, and the lights will be the brightest, and the stage will be the biggest at that point, and 40 might crack under the pressure. We've seen you do it, and I hate to make this about her choking, but I do feel like she don't have that same level of conviction like a Miss Hustle. Her voice just not, it just doesn't carry that same level of conviction, and it's a little light, and it's kind of like the Saga. Like, the bar could be crazy, but behind your voice, behind you saying it, it just don't have that same sell like somebody like Miss Hustle. She gonna be grimy. She gonna come in this bitch and try to punch your fucking head right off your body. Please wear them shorts.
Two big room-shaking rounds.
Please wear them shorts. For real.
Nakedness.
Wear them shorts. It's gonna be cold, but that ass though. You understand me? Ooh, shit. I got 40 winning this battle. I just don't see Hustle losing this battle. She got too much fucking time to prepare. I know she battled Twerk this year. She battled the shorty that was fucking teeth came out of fucking head or whatever happened. And then she got another battle with Vixen the Assassin. A 2-on-2. I think it's versus QP versus QP and Bankhead. I think that's what it is. Coming up soon. So she got plenty of time to prepare for this battle. And I'm sure she's been well aware of that for weeks now. So if we finding out, she probably been new for a little minute. She was battling 40. She got too much time to get ready for you, 40. And 40, even though lyrically she's one of the best out for female battle rap, I just don't see you beating Hustle. But hey, this is battle rap, man. Anything can fucking happen. You know what I'm saying? So we gonna see how it turn out. That's my predictions, though. Y'all tell me what y'all think, who y'all got winning and why down in the comments. You know I want to see who y'all got. It's your man Fatboy signing out the same way I always do. I respect the culture. I advise you niggas to do the same. Hey, Posey! Take us home, Lope.
Please don't unplug the game.